All right, the last thing I want to talk about is another thing that's more focused on the physics of the movement. So most of what we've talked about is mobility, stability, position, flexibility. How can I put my joints in the position that will allow these muscles to turn on effectively, that will allow me to have an appropriate range of motion? And the last thing we discussed was bringing the elbow away from the body to kind of change the physics of the movement, to put more stress on those upper back muscles so that we can, you know, look a little broader. The last thing I do want to say is it's another physics change, right? If I introduce a pause at the top and at the bottom of each rep, then I can kill the momentum. And now what does this do? So when I do motions that are quick, if I'm trying to develop this speed, this power, this quickness, I kind of want to let my muscle stretch and come right back into the next rep. We do that most specifically with a squat. On pretty much every squat that we do, it's the stretch shortening cycle, or maybe the stretch reflex as you've heard it. In doing that, I time my muscle contracture so that I can produce more force in general in my musculotendinous unit. But what I can do in the row instead is I can introduce that pause and I can kill that momentum so that instead of producing this force through the musculotendinous unit, through the connective tissue, the tendon, and the muscle, I can stop. I can prevent that stretch priming from happening. And I can increase the challenge by then having to generate that tension actively through the muscle. Now, I wouldn't only lift this way. I think you'll get really slow if you do it. There is a way to kind of balance both back and forth, but I wanted to talk about it in this because if I have this tool in my toolbox when I'm doing my rows, then I can easily manipulate a set. If maybe I didn't dial the weight in quite enough, let's say I'm doing 8 reps and I've got an 80-pound dumbbell and I get up there, I do my normal reps where I'm not pausing on everyone and I do 6. And at this point, I can tell I'm gonna do at least 10. Well, then on my 7th one, I can introduce a short pause to increase the challenge. And then I can pause on the 8th as well. And I can still add some reps so that this set is still really challenging, but I don't have to, you know, I don't have to keep going forever. I can increase the challenge acutely so that last set really feels like I've done something.